Here in Schematic, we'll do two things. We'll build a simple circuit and we'll set up the simulation. So the first thing I'm going to do is show you the palettes. They're all here. This is where you can get sources. This is where you get the actual simulation controller, such as the S-parameter simulation controller. It's just like putting a network analyzer, or in the case of harmonic balance, it's just like putting a spectrum analyzer on your test bench. I'll hit the escape key and that removes the component from my cursor. And if I select a component, and this is a simulation controller, and edit it, that is double click, it shows me the dialog. And you can refer to all the other videos for every one of the simulators. So I'm going to delete this one and go back to the palette, which is lumped components, and insert a resistor and an inductor. And notice when I insert these components, they're attached to the cursor. Even when I click to insert them, another is still attached. So to remove that, I simply hit the escape key, or you can use the N command. Either one works. And if we connect these, they automatically snap and a wire appears. And if you move the component around, it stays wired. Of course, you can change any of these things, including moving components without them being wired. And even the components, if you double click on them, always have a dialog box and all the parameters are shown here. You select a parameter, the definition is here, and if there are any settings, they're available over on the right. And you can select to display any particular parameter or not by this little box. Let's go ahead and cancel this. And let's finish building a simple circuit. I'll select a capacitor, and then I'll use my keyboard because there's key binding in ADS, and I'll simply rotate it and insert it. And I can use the wire icon here if I want, and that's just another way to wire it, and then get a ground. Now notice that I do not have to do anything extra here. I simply go to the next component and it's snapped. And now, because we want to do an S parameter simulation, I'm going to need terminations. And I could go back to the S parameter palette and I could get these terminations. Simply go to the palette and there they are, just like the calibrated ends of a network analyzer. Or for anything that you could find in a palette, you can also go to the library. And when the library appears, you simply expand any one of these folders, and here you can see Analog RF. That has all the palettes that you see here. There they are. And if you were to select one of these, then you would get the items in that palette. That's the components. You can search the library by component name or description. Just another way in ADS to insert components. Now let's complete our simple filter. I need another termination on the output, and to do that, I could either copy this one, go to the component history where I don't have to change to different palettes if that component's already been selected, or I could type it in, and it's just that easy. So if we copy it, let's select the copy command, and then we copy this component. Bring it right over here, hit the escape key, and notice that it's already marked termination 2, and the impedance is 50 ohms. Let's go ahead now and put grounds on. And now we're done. All we have to do now is run the simulation. So if you wanted to change any of the simulation settings, you simply double click on the controller and all the available tabs and settings are there. In this case, we'll leave it in the default. The last thing I'm going to do is use this icon to save the design. I've given it the name My Filter, as you can see, and now we're ready to simulate. And that means going to this icon, which is the simulation icon, and simply clicking. And when you do, you'll see the status window pop up, and it will give you all the information about the analysis. And it shows that the data set, which is the simulation results file, is written into our intro ADS project in the data directory. So now, let's plot the results in the data display window. Here's the data display window that popped up, and notice it has the same name as our schematic, and the data set has the same name. That always appears here. So we call this the default data set. Same name as schematic, and the window also has the same name. Let's go ahead and plot the transmission results, S21. Simply click on the rectangular plot, drag and drop it in, and the dialog now asks you what you want to plot by giving you the contents of that data set. So simply select what you want, in this case S21, we add it in dB, click OK, and here's our plot. And I'm going to also insert a Smith chart, and that way we can look at the impedance. Again, you get the same plot traces and attributes dialog. It shows you the data set and the contents. We can go ahead and take S11 and add it and click OK. And now you can see the trace here. I'm going to put markers on both of these. These are all the marker icons. Or you can use this command marker or key binding. And let me show you the results. Notice that I've changed the color of the two traces, and I've even thickened them. The markers have been placed, and you can change the marker readout for a Smith chart to show the impedance with a 50 ohm reference. And for any data point that you have, you can always move the marker with your cursor or select the readout and use the arrow keys, or you can type in the value that you want right on the screen. And finally, you can save all your work simply by clicking on the icon, and the little asterisk will go away. Now that is saved, and back in the ADS main window, you can use the file command to save all your work, close all your windows, or exit Advanced Design System. And as you can see, our project view now shows the design and data display window for the simple filter that we built. And you can always right-click on these items and see what options are available to you. And with that, we have covered the main window of ADS for starting and opening projects and controlling the files, the schematic window for building our circuits and setting up the simulation, running the analysis, and finally plotting our data in the data display window. And those are the basics of using ADS.